Well, I've been here 30 minutes now. Camera's a bit wonky, but it's straight for the other way, so I ain't gonna bother straightening it. Nothing's happened. to be honest with you, normally in these situations, you usually get a quick run if the fish are about, you know. And if they're having it, obviously. That's my experience. Basically, you know, this water being so deep, with all the layers of different temperature layers and everything else going on, you know, it's a stop-start to the start of the season, as it were. It's, you know, it's a little bit up and down. I think if they switch on, then, you know, you'll catch 3-4 fish. Otherwise, I think at the moment it's going to be a bit of a struggle. But, you know, I've got a bit of bait here and there, and I'm just going to keep on checking them spots. I know the ducks ain't had it all. So, yeah. Lucky thing about this place is most of the spots are sort of out of duck range. You know, they're sort of 6 feet down. So, yeah, I don't know what it'd be like if they had a young one. The mallards and that are going absolutely crazy in here at the moment. They're all mating. So they're all fighting amongst each other constantly, all night long too. Sometimes you can't tell the difference between a carp leaping out and a duck making me splashing. Last night I was sort of twitching all the time trying to work out if it was a carp or a bloody duck. So we've got a long day ahead of us, and at this time of year, you know, floater fishing really isn't going to be on the cards, I should think. So. I think I'll be just mooching around. I'm tired, so I reckon after I've given this an hour and a bit or so, I'll get back to the bivvy. I'll pop the rods back out and get some kit on me. I'll see. I'll get a few hours of the day away, and then we're into the evening. And yeah, we'll see what happens. If I catch over here, then I think what I'll probably do is move over here and leave that area there to itself. That bait will go eventually, there's no doubt about that. Yeah. But I've seen carp like this before, you know, they're just swimming around and they're just, you know, they're not feeding. So you can't catch them. Simple as that. But like I say, the more fish that wake up, the better my chances. Ooh. Well, I don't think those fish were feeding fish that were leaping and jumping around, because they're leaping and jumping around in here. Counted about 7 to 9 fish, a group of 7, basically under a tree. There's a ledge, it's all chalk, clean, and they're coming in one after another and rubbing themselves on it, and then they're leaping here and there. The water's getting just a little bit cloudy from what they're doing as well. And I think that's what they were doing in that corner there last night, and why that water was cloudy. It might not have been feeding. So I'm going to try and get up the tree to give you the best view. That's if they're still here doing it, of course. Spotted one over there already. Hold on. Take my glasses off. I can see what you can see. Hold on. Put my spectacles on. Okay. So down there, you'll probably just about see, is the white patch. They're basically circling, coming in here. One of them, right close in, and a couple of nice 20s, I tell you. I think they've buggered off. I thought they might.
just as I come to film it. So what I'll do while they're not around is I'll get up a tree and see if we can't get a decent view. But it's going to be difficult. Well, unfortunately, the sun's gone in, which doesn't make it easy. But there you go. There's the patch. Like I say, they were coming in there, and they were coming in real close as well, that bank, literally within inches of it. I kid you not. A big 20 came in. Mirror. It's not easy up here. Wish that sun would come out. See if I can find the fish. I'll go over there. Smaller ones just over there. Nothing down there on the spot though. Ducks over there fighting again. One just over there on that tree. Another one or two down here. I thought I saw just one fish moving along there, two fish moving along there, but it was one fish. Well, here you go. One, two, three. Oh, there's loads. Bloody hell, all of a sudden we've got one, two, three, four, five, six there, seven, eight, nine, ten. Loads of fish, and there's a couple of big ones. There's a big one coming in here now, real big one, broad across its back, blimey. That might be the big one that I've been seeing. There you go, there's one over the spot, just down there. Right, hold on, I've got to change glasses again so I can see what you can see. That way I can focus in a lot better. Hopefully they'll start doing, there you go, he's coming in. He's coming in. If the sun was out, we'd be able to see it a lot better. These bloody trees in the way don't help. Yeah, it's going to be difficult because I can only focus on the bloody trees. That one's a big one. That's a good 20, a very good 20. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They're all around, aren't they? Come on, Mr. Sunshine, come on out so we can see these bloody fish clearer. That's a good fish. That's a really good fish. So's that one and that one. There's a lot of 20s here, I tell you. You know, they outnumber the bloody doubles, that's for sure. In fact, so at the moment, this group here, there's not one fish under 20 pounds, I'd say. That one, fucking hell, that's a blonking great thing. In it comes. Where is it? There he is. There he is. That's a good fish. That's a good fish. Just swimming around though, you see. They're not doing a bloody great deal. Just swimming around. That's a good fish. There's three really good 20s here. And these are probably the old ones. You know, these are the 30, 31, 32 year old fish, or older obviously, because when they were put in here, they come from somewhere else. So, you know, they're 30 plus years old. They're well scaly old buggers, and they're well worth catching. See, if that's one fish, that's a big bugger. That's a big bugger. If that's one fish, that's a stonker. That's a stonker. It was that big. And that one over there, and that one. Crikey. I'll tell you what, I can't wait to get a few of these on the bank and have a real good look at them. That's another big one. Like a common. No, it's a mirror. It's another good size one down here. Coming in. Another one just there to the right. Just there, another one here. Now this is a good 20 as well. Looks like a common. Another one. Hmm. There's a couple of nice fish there. One's a small 20, one's a real good 20. Ooh, I want to catch them. So I've cleared away a few of the branches just so we can see that spot a bit more. Let's try and get that branch out of the way and we'll be set, won't we? And hopefully they'll come in and start doing it all again. There's one real close in over there, look. Look at that. That was a duck. Going over there, okay. So I've cleared those branches a bit better now. Come on, you buggers, start doing it again. But it was good, it was like they were all queuing up, one after the other, and there was one fish, a common, about 20 pounds. Seemed to be having trouble doing it, and kept circling, giving it another go. Now, I don't know if they were rubbing up against that branch there, or the bottom, you know? They seemed to be concentrating on that branch, but I couldn't be so sure. That's why I want to do it again. I want to watch them. And if I get them on film doing it, I can keep watching that film. Yeah. There's one over there at the moment. Just there. Every now and again, they seem to all come together, and there's a load of them. And that's what I like to see. When they all get together, they start behaving as one rather than as individuals, and behaviour is a little bit more predictable, and they seem to follow each other. And yeah, there's two really good fish coming in here now. These are nice ones, these ones. There's another fish joining them. Coming in. Come on. That is a big old mirror, I'll tell you what. That's a 30. Here we go. There you go. See that? Look at that. Wonderful. Oh, yes. You little beauty. Did you see how big that was too? Oh my word, there's loads of them out there. There's six or seven of them, look at them all. If they all start queuing up, you see, we'll get a good show. This is great, isn't it? This is as good as catching them almost. I love watching carp. You can learn so much about them. Know your prey, as they say. Oh no, let's just zoom out. At the moment I can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And there's a few this way as well. It's worth clearing all those branches away. We got a good view of that one, didn't we? That one coming close in. Look how close in they're coming. Look, the bank's just there. That's a big old kipper, that one. That really is. That's a big old kipper. Here we go. Ooh, look at him. Look at the size of that bugger. Ooh, that's a lump. These are all lumps. There's a lot of lumps here. Serious lumps for a little pond. Oh, I love it. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I should think there's 12 fish here and 10 of them are over 20. Easy. And there's at least one that I reckon's a 30. Look at them all over there. Brilliant. I want them to come back in here though. That's what I want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There they come again. That one hanging over there though. That's a porker. I do want that one. I want them all. Every single last one. Right, come on. Wind's died. Sun's out. Come on, guys. That's the width across that. It bloody hell. That's a nice one. Oh, my word. That's a 30, I tell you that. I don't care what anyone says. That's a 30. It's just too big not to be. Just too big. There he goes, one just hitting the surface now. That's a good 20. We're all grouping together again. I'm coming this way. Wish that bloody wind would drop. It is quite cold, that wind. My hand's getting cold holding this camera, I tell you. It's a little bit chilly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 fish. 12, possibly. 13. 14. 15, possibly. Here we go. There's one coming down now. I think this one's going to go for it. There you go. Doing it over there as well. You know, they keep seem to be queuing up and just patrolling over that spot there. It's a nice kipper. Comes another one. Whew. Spinning around, baby. And he's off. Yeah, I think they're doing it over there. There's that koi one over there as well. I can see it with the white line across its back. Actually, I think that's a different fish. This ripple's making it a bit difficult. Yeah, they're doing it over there as well. They're doing it over there, look. They've just sent up a cloud there. Here comes another one. Just under here. That fish there. Looks like a... There you go, look at them big buggers. That one in the middle. That one in the middle, look at it. Oh, look at that one, look at that one. There's some... Right, that one's there's a right old big thing. Cool. There's a lot of carp here. Look at him, look at him, look at him. Is he gonna flip? In he comes. Whee! Did you see that? Whee! Now why is he doing that, eh? Eh? Look at him. Thank you, mate. That was perfect timing. God. Unbelievable. You don't often get the opportunity to do this and to see this, you know, and it's like, there's no one else down here. It's quiet. I'm on my own. If I wasn't filming it, you know. So this is fun, sitting up a tree. There you go. Oh.
watching these carp. It's brilliant, isn't it? You learn so much about them, you know? You can't tell me that they don't communicate, because they do, you know? They've got forms of communication. They must have. Look at what they're doing, the way they're doing it together. Tell you what, when that sun goes in, and it is going in a lot more as that cloud moves over, it gets bloody cold. So, I'll make your mind up what you think they're doing. I'm going to research it a lot more, that's for sure. Obviously, I've got one or two theories of my own, and obviously I've heard and read about one or two theories. But carp are not the only fish to do this. I've noticed aquarium fish doing this as well. So I'm going to look into it and see if I can come up with something. I think they've disappeared. I don't know where they've gone. Oh, there you go. He did it. He had a little go. And they're on it, aren't they? It's a concerted thing that they're dealing with. They're single-mindedly doing this at the moment. And not all of them, but most of them. You know? Right, well, I think we've probably seen all that we're really going to see. So, oh, here comes another one. Is he going to do it? He's coming in. He veered off at the last moment. Right, okay. Just saw something roll over there. Corner of my eye. Like I say, I don't think they're feeding fish. They're doing something else, aren't they? Well, we're over the other side of the lakes. Two fish there. I spotted another fish over here when I got over here. But there wasn't anything in the snag at all. And there still isn't. And they're the first two I've seen over here. Apart from that, like I say, that one other fish. So I should think most of the fish that are awake are over there at the moment, doing what they're doing. Right. Let's get back to the original swim. Pick up the rods, bring them back over here. Stick them out. I don't hold out much hope for the day, sticking them out. I'll stick them out anyway. All the bait's still there, so. Bit of a grueler really, isn't it? Apart from that thing there, I mean. You know, it's a trip worth that alone, I think, to be honest with you. It's always good to see stuff like that, and I've seen it a few times, of course, but never managed to get it on film quite like that, so pleased to know that. But yeah, all the bait's still there, where the ducks can't get to it. There you go. Yeah, last week they were all in here, weren't they? All in this area here, this week. Over there. Wouldn't surprise me though if they finish over there, they'll move on to the back of the wind. I still favour this swim over the point here, or the original that I'm in at the moment, the rods. There you go, you can see the drop off. You can see the boilies on there as well. One just teetering on the edge. Flat boilies is what you need here, so you don't roll. There's a fish. That's a double. He's on his own, he's coming in. Just stand still, shouldn't notice me. Barely see him. I shouldn't think you could see him at all, can you? No. I've got my poles on, I keep forgetting. Right. Back to the rods. Go at the local shop. I think that's what I'll do. I'll get back to the rods, take them back over there, sort it all out, leave them out, get my shit together, whip up the local shop, and get some much needed chocolate.
Definitely, yeah.
See, that's cheered me up already. And by the time I get back, I'll have a nice kip. Rods will be all out and set. Happy days.
Yeah, I might get one this evening. That was cool though, wasn't it, watching them? Right.
I was making my way around and it suddenly occurred to me that all these fish here,
one of them might take a bright pink pop-up. Just out of curiosity. They're still all around here, there's one just over there now. My pink pop-up is down there. You probably can't see it. I can just about make it out. It just shows up every now and then. It's just down there somewhere. Anyway. I thought, yeah. You know, there's several fish here. 15 fish, possibly. There you go, they're just around the other side here. Just over there, here you go. You know, I thought, oh God, there's loads of fish there. Loads of them. Never know, do you? Oh, one just came straight out of the water over there. I'll probably do it again somewhere. Right of where it came out. There's one. There you go. There's one coming straight in. Straight in. Oh, it's coming straight in. No. Moved away. Let's see if I can sink that line a bit more. But not while they're around. It's fairly well sunk. It's a lot deeper there than you think. I just think that pop-up's in 6 foot of water. I often feel if you get like a group of them, you know, two, three or more together, they tend to act more stupid. More likely to take a bait. And that thing is quite obvious, I can see it clear as day from here. I bet they bloody can too. There comes one, one's coming in above it. I tell you, if they all come round at once and get over that pop-up, I reckon one might take it. I really do. Here comes one. Littler one. Closer. No. Ooh, that moved away. That looks sus. I think the line's not, I think I'm pretty sure the line's on the bottom. I was very careful. There's another one. Moving in. Another one coming from the right. One's facing it, moving in. No, it's turned away. See if I can do something about that line while they're not all around. Over there at the moment. The line is completely sunk beautifully. As I was doing it, the fish moved in, took a look, pissed off. But it definitely moved in and took a look, and it was only a really small one too. So there you go. I had a look. It's always nice when it has a look, at least. They're still around, so I'm going to stay here for a little while longer. In the chance that I might get one. I ain't worried if it ain't one of the big ones. Any fish will do. Here you go, here comes one in. Oh, it looks like... Ooh, that went straight over there. There's another one coming. That's turned away as well. They don't like it, do they? There's a little... That was a little common. Went straight in. There's another one over it. I tell you what, they're coming and looking. They're bloody coming and looking. Well, they're still swimming around. Up and down they're going. Difficult to see them now. Even with Polaroids on, just about make out the dark shape. There's one circling right in front of the bait, right now. Should be able to tell if it goes down on it. That's the good thing about these choddies is they pick them up. You generally can't get rid of them. Here comes one from the right, just down here. It's coming in, it's coming in, it's definitely coming in. I think it's a little bit too high in the water and it's moved away by the looks of it. Yeah, well, we'll give it a go. As long as these carp are here, I might as well give it a go, eh? There's fish in the area and there's a bait in the water. Two vital ingredients to catching carp.
Also plenty of determination. See how different this place is though to St Ives. This is why I joined it. I mean, I know it's not as awesome as St Ives is, but it is awesome in its own little unique ways. And when you come on pools like this, it becomes much more intimate and you get much more close up, as we did there, you know, as we are over there fishing at our feet all the time. And you know, so all those really important things come into play. Paying attention to detail, being really quiet, being really careful, creeping around, putting a little bit of bait here and there, leaving your rods out for a while, resting the swims, getting up trees, walking about, talking to your mates.
Sun's come out again. Let's go and have a look for them. There's none that I can see just here. There's one there at least, possibly two. No, that's just one. Just holding station. Another one coming in from the left there. I'm just going to have a look around the corner here and see what they're doing. Oops. The other day, you see, they were coming around a point like this. All the time. There's one. Move it out. There's one, two, three, four, five, six. They're still around. Still about. There's the ducks diving under that tree after them boilies, I think, possibly. Yeah. Couple of nice lumps out there. Let's get back around the corner here. So I'll give this bright pink pop up 20 minutes or so. Then what I'll do is I'll swap over the other rod and put out the lemon sole pop up. Not quite as obvious. Different smell, because that one's got the berry smell to it. Oh, they've started up the machine over there. I shouldn't think that worries the carp one bit. I'm probably completely used to it, but if I started up a generator, not only would I have all the anglers want to shoot me, they probably spooked the fish. So let's see what their reaction is to that. Well, they're still around. One there, one there, one there, one there. Well, another one's just swam past. So I think I'll put that lemon sole pop up out and take that one in. It's just a gentle swing, so no disturbance at all. If I keep low, keep quiet on that crunchy gravel, should be alright. Could wait for the farmyard to start up to disguise my noise. Right, it doesn't seem to be anything too much about, so I'm gonna nip down there, change the pop-ups. And what I might do is sling that orange one under that tree there. There's a couple of 3, 4, 5, 6 carp out in front of us here. Oops. I'll just stand still. I'm drifting in. Here they come. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One's coming in. That's turned away. One's coming quite close to the bank. Parallel now, turned away. I really don't want to move, but I've got to get down. I can still see the spot from there. Drifting in. I don't really do anything at the moment, so I'll wait until they bug it off. Well, then the sole pop ups out. Pink ones in. Listen to him. That's the digger loading up the lorry. Hopefully he won't be going for too long. Doesn't seem to bother the fish. They're used to it. So we'll leave this out for a while and see what their reaction is to this. It's all interesting stuff. Right in front of us at the moment. Just idly swimming by. Round here. No, nothing in there. You can see one there straight away. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So yeah, still numbers of carp around. Patience is a virtue. Oh, what's the time? I never know what the time is. That's the beauty about fishing. You just lose all track of it, don't you? Okay. It is... Hold on. No, it's only 4:30, that's good. I thought it was a lot later than that. I've had about, I must have had an hour's kip. I spent a couple of hours over there trying to nab one of those fish, but couldn't get one. So I came over here, got the rods all sorted out, tossed them back out again, hit the sack. Hold on a second. Also made myself a half cup. Oh, I'll tell you what, there's the stone. These half cups are pucker, they really are. So, I've just been reviewing that film. I took over there, honestly, fantastic. I just love it when that happens. I think we're going to get a lot of that this year. We're going to get a lot of up close, hopefully filming them, taking the bait,
spitting out rigs, all sorts of stuff. I'm going to try and film it. I'm literally going to try and set the tripod up and try and do that. And I'm just so looking forward to fishing here. And you know, it's just like a local pond. It's nothing special. It's not as awesome as St Ives, but it holds secrets. It's got some amazing old lumps. It's got an intimacy and the difference that it brings to my fishing, and I'm just really excited. It's tough at the moment, but I've just seen a double figure mirror on the bottom feeding on my boilies on the left hand rod. So I think we might be in with a real good chance of getting a fish tonight. I very rarely come out here because I prefer to stay. Now they've been, today it was, when I got back, it was really sunny, this was all calm, and they were all out in the middle, right on the top, which was a great sign because it means the water's warmed up a lot more. I'm just looking for dark shapes on the bottom. I got to about here and I saw one down there. And I think I can see another one, possibly, I don't know. It's not moving, so that means it's either tipped up and feeding, or it's not a carp, but it looks like a bloody carp to me. I'm sure it is. It's really difficult to see. So obviously the light level's gone down. I think perhaps I'm just looking at shadows. You do that, don't you? You think you see a carp just sort of in the windy bit. You keep staring at this dark sort of area and you realise it's just a tree above you. Casting a shadow, casting a darker reflection, I should say. So, okay, I'm just gonna leave the spot. I can't tell if any of the baits have gone, because like I say, I put three good anvils out. Middle rod's in about 8 foot, 9 foot. It's a nice size roach, just went by. Must bring my roach rod with me here and do a little bit of roach fishing when we're quiet, as it were. There's millions of the buggers in here. I'll be doing a bit of pike fishing on this water this winter as well. Plentiful supply of perch as well, big ones apparently, so I'll be doing a bit of perch fishing this summer hopefully as well, and autumn and winter. This place shouldn't be too bad. They were catching up until December, and then I think they started catching again in February, March, something like that, so yeah. Right. I'm going to finish this half cup coffee, sit back, and see what tonight brings. I think we're in with a chance. The conditions have improved no end. There's a lot more fish active today. I've just seen that mirror, and it was on the deck, and it was feeding on my bait. So yeah, definitely, we could be within a chance. I don't want to say definite because, of course, last night I was pretty sure I was going to get a fish. So there you go. Right. Let's drink this coffee. can of gas, boils it in 30 seconds flat. Where's my coffee? As you can see, I'm getting through my coffee. Last week I finished off a whole bag of this. So if you ever come for my swim, if you ever come for tea, I've got some Earl Grey and some Yorkshire tea as well. I've been curing the Yorkshire tea once for about a year. So this is a two-thirds cup. Normally for a whole cup, it's two spoons like that. Yeah. For a half cup, it's half the amount of water, and four spoons like that. I think I'll have a two-thirds cup, so I'll have two good heaped spoons. Can drink too much strong coffee. Still got these sunglasses on, don't really need them, but I do when I'm out there spotting the fish. I'm getting used to being under an umbrella. In a bivvy, everything's inside and you've got loads of room, everything's outside pretty much, with a brolly, so I've been spilling loads of stuff. I've spilled 50% of my porridge. It's lucky I bring plenty. So I've got porridge oats all over the place. Spilled coffee yesterday. There you go. We'll just let that come off a boil. They say it's about burning the coffee. That ain't. It's about not pouring boiling water over your coffee. Pour it from a height and you get lots of air in it. And that's the important thing, getting the air in it. Shake. Oh, it's really dark colour. Lovely. I quite often drink tea during the day and in the evening, but fancy coffee at night. Now that is what you call coffee. So if you want a coffee when you come to my swim, this is what you get. I've got milk and I've got sugar, if you want. So, there's a fair amount of bait out there still. I probably put out half a kilo last night, good half a kilo. But when I was here last week, and I watched Ian Fisher's swim, when I was over in the original first night, he came along with pre-bait, and he put in 24 handfuls, and they're good handfuls, you know. So I reckon that was about 2 kilos of bait. Maybe a kilo and a half. The next night he put in, I think it was 12 good handfuls, 6 on each rod. I think he had 2 rods out. Fish on the surface out there. And he obviously kept up the bait. So that tells me that they'll eat a lot of bait. Now I saw this. Those fish over there. There was 15 fish, and I should think 10 of them were 20s, which surprised me because there's a lot more doubles in here than there is 20s. A couple of the fish that have been caught already this year, the weights have been down. That 13 I had was a bit thin, wasn't it? So again, you know, it surprised me to see so many large fish that just looked every bit 20 pounds, but there could be a number of upper doubles there, you know, that are looking 20, but perhaps not. But at least 5 of them were well over 20, you know, and there was the one that was just a big lump. You know, so it'd be interesting to see what they weigh, I guess, when they get them on the bank. It's funny, isn't it, the fascination with the weight of them and what that matters. You know, how that matters, I should say. I very rarely weigh fish that I think are under sort of 15, 20 pounds now. Here they want me to weigh them all because they want to see how they're doing, and I appreciate that and will do that. I rarely take pictures of fish, even 20 pound fish now, and I just take a snap off the film, which isn't as good quality, but you know, I always find that photographing fish, I've always got a set routine in my mind, so I know exactly what I'm going to do if I catch a fish, which is always helpful, because if you just sort of plan what you're going to do, and when you do catch a fish, you're not flustered, you know exactly what you're doing, and you get on with it. But even so, you know, you've got to take the fish out, put the fish back in, take it out, it gets a bit fresh maybe, after you've been resting it and all the rest of it. So I find that, you know, getting them out of the water, lifting them up in front of the camera straight away, you know, after a few minutes resting in the net, they're not too fresh, they're handleable, you know. Why bother taking pictures? I mean, I don't look at them. There's very few fish that I ever look at, pictures I look at. I've got some up my wall now, in my tackle room. Some of my favourite fish. But, yeah, it's the memory in the moment that's more important to me than the picture, really. But the pictures, you know, can bring back the memories. But I guess for me, it's a bit different, isn't it? Because I've got all the film as well, so I don't really need the pictures, if you know what I mean. Yeah. Babbling. I'm just really blissed out. I'm really happy. Oh, that's good. That's good. No one's ever complained about my coffee. Except once. And, yeah. They make better coffee than I do, but they use stupid amounts of coffee, I think I've already mentioned. And they didn't complain, they just didn't drink it. Yeah. Okay. I took a picture of this scene this morning. Yeah. Let's just spin you around and straighten you back up. Ooh. Oh God. Yeah. Took a picture of that this morning. And hundreds of you liked it. Even though it's got a ruddy great digger in the background. It does look good, doesn't it? That's that platform that just, you know, it sets the scene, doesn't it? Beautifully. It's the symmetry of it that I love about this scene. It's got such lines and yeah. It's not a bad place to be fishing. Challenge, some great fish, loads to learn. I mean, you know, after that filming today up in that tree, just think how much more of that we've got to come. I don't know how many fish we're going to catch along the way, but it's going to be a lot of fun.
Carp on the surface just out there, and it's just disappeared again as soon as I get the camera out. In that area there. Well, it's gone six. Dinner's on. Sausages and oven squeak. As you can see, I cut my sausages up, they cook a lot more evenly. So I'll basically cook this through pretty much, and then I'll finish off the sausages. And then the two will go in the pan together. That's had one flip already, or one or two. That should take about 10 minutes or so. There's a fair amount there, and that's homemade bubble and squeak. It's a real McCoy. So there's a number of carp moving up and down this bank here at various levels. I've gone and checked the bait that I put in the snag, still there. So yeah, it doesn't seem like they're really feeding, does it? No rolling or anything like that, or breaching. Just cruising around aimlessly on or near the surface. Like I say, you get a couple of those lumps moving and they'll soon polish off that bait. So we'll see what the evening brings. Overnight and the morning. Last night, last chance. But it's been a good session already. That footage today, sitting up in that tree, moving around, getting to know things a little bit better, a little bit more. You know, all helps. Nothing turns out as you plan it. Life's full of surprises. The trick is to enjoy them. So there you go. Dinner's almost ready. Sausages are just finishing off. This has the bubble and squeak. Got some Tabasco and tomato sauce. I'm going to have to improve my condiment selection. There's no doubt about that. I think brown sauce yet again would have been better, but there you go. I keep forgetting when I go shopping. I'll make a list. I reckon that's ready. Yeah, I know, it'll scratch the teeth out. Done. I'll be chewing bits for an hour or so. Hopefully the carp are as hungry as I bloody was. I polished off about £3 of bubble and squeak there. Happy days. Cowl on. Where's the cowl? Yes! Well, it's just gone 8 o'clock. It's getting lighter and lighter all the time. Nights are getting shorter, days are getting longer. Well, the carp were still on the surface up to about 3/4 or so an hour ago. It's just gone 7, I think it was the last time I saw one. Hopefully tonight, tomorrow morning, they'll get their bloody heads down and eat some bait. But I have come across this before, and all of a sudden, they'll switch on and start catching. Okay. Gonna get my bedroll sorted. Settle in for the night.